back it up here.
I want to see Philly represent when this shit drop.
Hey, OG, I like it up here.
I love it up here, man.
At
this time, we want to receive with a rousing round of applause our beloved Captain Dead, Muhammad's Mosque number 12 in Philadelphia, Brother Captain Gregory Tuhan.
Rap music.
Fuck what people got to say. I don't give a fuck.
Hip-hop is writing and rhyming.
This is hip-hop music, and this is all we got.
A way of life. To hold the mic in your hand and crush whoever's in front of you. That's hip-hop.
You'll be gonna get these. You'll be running back and please.
Come on. Like,
hip-hop, sir.
Keep it down. You have no need to think that your instructions have already been thought out.
If a nigga gonna get me, a nigga gonna get me. Ain't like I can't be got. It's just gonna be hard as fuck.
If you don't have the proper identification, you will not be permitted to come in. Lock it down.
I'm not leaving the ghetto shit. He said, that's fly. Kids want to hear that.
Brothers, people with tickets have no special privilege.
You don't even know what we're going to do next. We got so many hits.
And it was actually a piece of paper that's saying that, saying he gave away his hits for a watch and a motherfucking chain.
And just like a piece of sizzling, it fit inside my stomach with the exit just between.
Never had nothing to believe before they had records. They talked all that shit and then they did it.
When money get involved in this shit, that's when niggas start making mistakes.
The ones who did it and didn't talk shit, they don't want to do it.
That you did personally use a firearm.
Here comes the brand new flavor, yeah.
If I was not in the studio and not doing this shit right now and in this motherfucking trailer, you know what I'm saying, and doing this positive shit, I'd probably be right in your motherfucking house right now, tying your ass up in your fucking safe, slapping your kids around on the real.
Brand new flavor. Flavor, yeah. Come on.
So all the wannabes tonight could have been, has been, gonna go in the bin.
Assalamu
alaikum.
What is the time, sir?
Hot. Hey.
Beat. For what?
Wow.
Oh, I've been to Rikers before, yeah. Yeah, but I ain't, you know, I ain't one of them niggas that like to visit people. They fucked up when they in jail. I gotta hear them. They call collect on the phone, but I'm not coming. I'll send you commissary, but I'm not coming.
Once upon a time, not long ago, when people wore pajamas and lived life slow.
I don't wanna come visit no rappers in jail. I'm saying, for what? It sold a million too. I wish, you know, I mean, it's supposed to be. I mean, I'm not no role model or nothing. I'm not trying to be, you know. But I don't think, you know, if you got all that success, you can't, you know. And I want, you know, I always tell artists, you know, it's all right to be, you know, to be real. Real is, you know, everybody say, I wish I got to where you got. If I got to where you got, I would not be throwing no guns in nobody's faces or robbing nobody or none of that. Or just being in, somebody got a beef with me, believe me, they could go. I'm only going to see Ricky because of the movie. I'm saying that's the only reason. You gotta cut it out?
Cut that line.
Well, you should make it real. Come on, and you know, I don't understand. I'm older though, I'm 37 years old. I wanna travel around the world and chase famous models. I'm still always gonna be ghetto. I'm too old not to be. You know what I'm saying? I'm who I am, but I ain't gotta do, you know what I'm saying? I'm not broke, so I ain't gotta throw no guns in nobody's faces for nothing. I don't even wanna see no guns if I can help it. I got a Rolls Royce. I don't feel like hurting nobody. I don't want nobody near me with no type of drama. Only drama I want is Naomi Campbell. I'm not fucking with Ricky. I don't even know what he's gonna talk about. That nigga called me 4 times. I missed each call. I don't know what he wants his jewelry. I know that much.
That's kind of fly, you know. That's his ego talking. That's why his records are so dope. He'll tell you in a minute. All of them is crumbs, and they all want to be me.
Hi, ladies and gentlemen, and you peasant poor pieces of trash.
Ego talking. You know, that's the type of shit he would say on his records. They all want to be him, the ruler. And he used to play that shit, the ruler.
The name is Slick Rick, the ruler, the rich ruler, by the way.
Oh, man, have you seen the pictures of him with the king hat on and the jewelry? He was as crazy as a bag of angel dust. I mean, personally, crazy.
What's up, Daddy?
How you make it out in here, kid?
Appreciate your freedom a lot more, you know? The little things. You know, you don't be so materialistic afterwards. Stuff like that, you know? Appreciate family, life, all that good stuff, you know? So when the album's supposed to drop? November the what?
November 22nd, I think.
November 22nd?
That's perfect for that Christmas money. It's gonna be good.
A lot of the music, as good as we think it is, or Warren G did a good job, it ain't 100% you, and people are waiting for your music. So when you come home, you know, we just, you know, see what you do on your own. I know you feel like it could be better.
Hey, I don't got nothing against no producers. I mean, everybody got their props or they wouldn't be producers. You know what I'm saying? It's just that this man can't be me and I can't be him. You know what I'm saying? He might make good music like Warren G and Snoop. They got their own style, you know what I'm saying? And Pete Rock or then this one and that one, they got their style. And their shit sells when they work together with. But if you put this with this, sometimes it just don't mix, you know what I'm saying?
We can't understand how these kids get these opportunities. Like, you know, they got this gift, they make these records, they get success. And instead of taking that success and doing the right thing, a lot of them take that success and as a green light to go to hell, to do all the wrong shit. And that, to me, is a shock. But I keep seeing it more and more. And not to name any artists, but a lot of artists, even the ones that aren't in the news because of it, they got with their hit record comes a lot of drama that they don't need.
The country, the world is bugging out as it is, you know? Brothers are just talking all type of mad stuff. I guess that's the way they feel like expressing themselves. But then when they have their shows and stuff, they got to live up to that image because they drawing a crowd that's on some rah-rah.
Yo, check it out, straight from Brooklyn, represent.
You be like, you think
Because I know how niggas is. When you in the streets and you hustling, you know how niggas is because you was one of them niggas, you know what I'm saying? You on the corner, you trying to get your money, you see a nigga roll a Vine, a Benz, or a Beamer, you know what I'm saying? You're like, fuck that nigga, you know what I'm saying? Fuck, I stopped, I murdered that nigga, I robbed that nigga, you know what I'm saying? Now, I'm the nigga in the Benz and the Beamer, you know what I'm saying? Driving past other corners, so I know the same speech is coming out, you know what I'm saying? But it's all good, though. I ain't tripping. I'm that nigga.
Prior to 13 years of age, he was just a son that any mother would like. Mm. At 13, he became notorious.
Uh-huh. And then when I started doing the music and I started like slipping shit out in the music and shit, she was like, I didn't know Christopher did this and I didn't know he did that. She would always come in and see the drugs and shit. And I'd be like, it's Chico's. You know what I'm saying? My mom's used to do some wild shit, man. Throw my work in the toilet. She used to put knives to Chico neck. Shit like that. Just bugging, like. But it's like, it was nothing she could do to stop a nigga. Like, I tell her I'm gonna stop. I ain't gonna fuck around no more. She'd kick me out the crib. But I just, like, come back in, tell her I ain't doing it, and still be doing it. Ready to Die was 95% the chronic, 5% of me. All the rest of that shit was the weed, man. All that suicidal thought shit, all that little extra shit that niggas ain't really supposed to be talking about, that was the weed talking, man. Blame that on a lot.
It's censored on the radio. You don't hear, I think, what he's really saying.
I wasn't really looking at it as like, well, how am I feeling right now? I feel like killing myself. I'm gonna write a rhyme about it. It wasn't like that. I was just thinking like, damn, I remember when I used to be stressed out in the same fucking room, you know what I'm saying? And like, it wasn't to the point where I was like, I want to kill myself. I was just like, damn, my baby mom's stressing me. My mom's stressing me, you know what I'm saying? Niggas ain't fuck with me, you know what I'm saying? I ain't got no money. I'm broke. The av is hot and they can't get no money. A nigga just be like, yo, the fuck, if I was dead, I wouldn't have to worry about nothing. I could just lay up, either I'd be in heaven or hell, I'd just be laying the fuck up, just chilling. I wouldn't have to worry about no problems. That's what I was on. I wasn't on no killing myself shit. I was just saying if I was dead, I'd be a lot better off. And sometimes I still be feeling like that. Say, all these fucking motherfuckers want to stress a nigga out over some bullshit, some rap shit. It's supposed to be fun.
We introduce everybody, so everybody you know.
This is Warren G, you know what I'm saying?
Is it going platinum yet, Johnny? It's platinum now.
Almost double.
Double?
It'll be double by the end of next week.
Explain to them what double means, platinum.
2 million records, you know, CDs, tapes.
Okay.
So.
Hey, Warren G! Hey, Warren G!
What?
You gotta hurry up, Coolio already on!
I just want to be able to talk to somebody tonight.
Once you get off schedule, when you're doing one of these tours, that are long-distance tour dates, over 500 miles per day, you got to be rolling. You got to be almost rolling like an express. And if you get off schedule, it's all fucked up.
I forgot 5 o'clock, the Black Press wants to see him in the lobby. All right, that's important. We never see them.
So I ain't gonna get to do nothing, huh?
You gotta be quick. You can do
this happen in every city, and then I gotta leave.
No, this doesn't happen every city.
5 footers in the house. This is a 5 foot session. Neb is in the house, motherfucker. I'm not stressing. At my best and on the microphone, it's me, the NEB, feeling Irie. When I hit the spliff, I got to get to a bliff. Any nigga or negro with the fro in the back, yo. Pass the flow to my homegirl, Josh Skills. Beatboxing, cuz we're on the real.
So, what's up with the 5 footers?
We can work this out, but what they don't like, so I guess they're gonna send in conditions. I guess they want the hairdresser.
Yeah, no. I ain't paying for the shit.
Come on, Warren. Every group has the hairdresser.
I ain't paying for no motherfucking hairdresser. If they want that shit, but be my guest.
Sorry, I think
I'm supposed to just say fuck them and change the motherfucker.
You can do the hair. We're braiding.
They got braids in their hair, so what? I mean, what's that?
This is called ghetto burning. When you burn your hair, when it
turns
frizzy.
They got braids in their hair, but they need a hairdresser. What else he say, Uncle Ronnie?
Basically, wish he would firm up a little early in the game than waiting until he has to blow up. He makes his own decisions.
Conditions, this. They act like I'm getting paid $60,000 or something. I'm just saying all this trying to be business, talking about conditions, and this is the conditions we... Conditions for what? I mean, hey, Neb, if y'all gonna come, y'all gonna have to let us know something. We gotta know today for sure.
They still have a production contract with Warren. You let them out of the contract?
Yeah. If they really want to get out.
Well, let's ask them again.
I ain't about holding nobody. That's what it is about me.
We work the situation
If I ain't gonna work with you, what's the use of me holding you?
Still, there's another difference, and there's another difference.
I'll let you go. Mm-hmm. It ain't no thing to me, because you're not making me or breaking me. The music industry breaks. When you come in as friends, it breaks you up. It breaks you up. Got them five swiggers in their pocket.
It ain't them. It's a man.
Well, he twisting their ass up. You about to fuck them up.
You just tell us what you want, and let's get on with this tour. And incidentally, Gil, you're not holding the tour up, because we did our first night last night.
And blew it up.
And it was the shit.
That's Ron G at his best, baby. At his best. That's why my business is taken care of so swell.
All right, y'all. Ready to go? Ready to go.
Throw your hands in the motherfucking air and wave the motherfuckers like you just don't care.
If you puff on the weeds, hey, I do that shit. I do that shit. Oh, I do that shit. And if your ass got a buzz, hey, I drink that shit. I drink that shit. Oh, I drink that shit. When it's the Zuper, the Duper, the Land Cruising Trooper, Tic Tacs that time, they hang up around like Mr. Cooper. I'm taking you to a zone that's been for a whackness, so please get your damn
butter.
Yo, oh no, grab a hold of Adabo's, getting her flows on like JoJo runs in a marathon. Smooth like jumpers, don't call me Big Mama Kane. Feels like another one's going out for her brain. Step back, because I happen to be on that plus tax. Got more subscribers than they feel hearts in a mat. Mal after mal, I rip style after style. Cracked open all the fat.
Ooh, I'm glad I used that, yeah.
Cause it kick it back when I'm singing my song. But I just flow on your song.
That's kicking cause I roll on.
And then I hear Ron Coon. Been a rep. That's how I got the motherfucking super on my chest. Now if you pop on the weeds, I do that shit. I do that shit. Oh, I do that shit. And if your ass got a buzz, say I drank that shit. I drank that shit. Oh, I drank that shit.
I'm gang related, you know what I'm saying? I can't avoid it. You know what I'm saying? I got homies that gang bang, got uncles that bang, I got. It's just I'm gang related. Even if I don't gang bang, my mama live in a gang related neighborhood. So when I go through that hood, I'm gonna say, what's happening, cuz? And I'm treated as a gang member. So I'm gang related.
It doesn't matter, come from the East Coast or the West Coast. So that means, on that note, put your hands together for my peoples, Snoop Dogg and the Dogg Pound.
Put your motherfucking hands in the air and you don't
motherfuckers. Make some motherfucking noise.
What up, Philadelphia?
Fuckers hit the deck, I gets wrecked with a check, so passion like checks, yeah. I got my own back in the scrap, but if it calls for that, I got my nigga Kenny Mack, yeah. Hey, trip is the wind, Mack 10's in my nigga's clutches, so bust this, we rush this, punk ass nigga, I knew he was a fucking punk, so then I tap dad, go to the fucking trunk, we step back in with the tech, and I'm all pumped, puffin' no blunt, ready to get wrecked, even though I knew he had a Mack 10, no, I gave a fucking stuff to take out the window, ready to let
loose,
get some gin and juice, and then tell Snoop to come scoop, check me out, peep how all who withstand, step so quick and slowly sink like quicksand, murder, that's what I'll be yelling, I'm peeping, you're peeping, the two fucking hoods, the felon, but I'm seeing a dick, putting looks in a beanie, trying to mad dog, you can't see me. I can bust a cap and fit him up, ready to get him up. I said, what that dog bell like, nigga?
Then I hit him up.
Come now on, you niggas shit. Know what's up with corrupt. Come on, niggas don't give a fuck, I'm headed to the west side.
Now this spot's shown by the motherfucking D-O.
Double G.
P-O-U-N-D, so I see no
other choice.
But to roll with the homicide.
For all this drama, make sure you and your mama dies.
Cause this is Dog Pound for life.
Sing it.
Come on, nigga, I just don't give a fuck.
This is Dog Pound.
Come on, come on.
This is
motherfucker, we just don't give a fuck.
If you was told your whole life that you wasn't gonna be shit, that's what you gonna think, you ain't shit. You understand? Because it's all about thinking. If they pump you up like Lil Johnny, you can You could be a lawyer or a basketball player. That's going to make you want to do that. You know what I'm saying? It's only the truth. And we just tell the kids and shit, as far as our music is concerned, from what we grew up, is that you could be whatever you want to be, but the life that we had to live was out there, was rough, it was hustling, it was gangbanging, it was out there, and there ain't nothing we could do to change it, but that's how we lived, and we trying to figure out how can we change it by expressing it, letting y'all know that we done did it already. So, I mean, save yourself and don't go through that shit.
It's cool, you know what I'm saying, man? I mean, I'm sure everybody's upset about it. It's like everybody wants to say, yo, we've seen it, we lived it, and we ain't having it. That's what all the rappers is really saying. You know, they try to represent their neighborhoods, whatever. But we all seen it, we all lived it, and we all ain't having it. And now we gotta move on to something else. You know what I'm saying? Okay, everybody, everything. Next man, I carry a bazooka. Next man, I got a tank. You know, all that's cool, you know what I'm saying? Trying to diss nobody, but you know, gotta move on, you know what I'm saying? Cause shit, we front of our homeboys, but we still gotta go home to Mom Dukes, you know what I'm saying? We can't front around Mom Dukes 24/7. Yo, Mom, what up? You know what I'm saying? Put the stash away, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Everybody got respect for their parents, you know what I'm saying?
We gangsters. We gangsters, we all do the same type of shit. It's something about being a dog pound gangsta, claiming DPG for life. That gangster shit, that shit that the bust ass niggas talk about doing, wanna do. Act like they can do, but no, they can't do it. You know what I'm saying? It's like this. We ain't preaching about doing no hellified ass shit. We just speaking the real straight from the heart. All the shit we talk about is real.
I mean, it's not like I got a problem with gangster rappers, because sometimes they telling their life the way they, you know, it's all they see.
See, it's another, the other thing is,
and it's informative, it's helpful, but when other people come along and they just do it because they think that's their ticket.
Back on the street, straight through and break, cause I represent like every day. Nigga, you can't tell me I don't see no less spot. When I can tell you all the homies that we got shot from at least about 5 years ago, when I was in junior high, going to Marshall. The homie used to come up to the school and rock, and leaving out of bitches, fly with job. Been in the winter days of the past. This is the pizza I bought, we been whooping niggas ass. Everybody a blast. And if you don't believe me, nigga, you can ask the homie that. And that's your ass. You fucked around and let us, you take your cash. He didn't even run, he walked away. Cause I didn't see that night. I wish I was dead, I would've clapped. But that's why we asked your bitch ass for the pass. Cause he wouldn't even squad back. Man, we can't fuck with no niggas like that. He'll get us all cracked. Police was behind us, he wouldn't even jump out with the strap. Now that's what I call a B.I.G. I said he couldn't watch you to drop out of the club.
And some of these niggas are the bitches too. And some of these niggas look just like you. So if you ever been told on, go out and get your roll on, you ass nigga, you get stoned.
Dog pound, Daz and Corrupt. Two wild ass motherfuckers don't give a fuck about nothing. You know what I'm saying? They just want to make some records, make some money.
Yeah, I mean, that's our clique, you know what I'm saying? There's a distinction, you know? Like, when we say dog pound can mean all of our homies, but when we on record, we represent all of our homies, you know what I'm saying? This is the dog pound right here, gangsters. We the group, you know what I'm saying? Me and Dad.
The homies just putting it down.
Yeah, we the ones that put it down on the mic.
As far as the chemistry, they clicked. For as him and Snoop, him and Daz, they all became like brothers. And it is, you know, join in and break each other, made some shit happen. Yep. Therefore, as you know, I ain't with that Hollywood shit. I like these little niggas because they gangsters. You know what I'm saying? They ain't with all that punk shit. They don't care about trying to have their hair done a certain way. They ain't caring, like, you know what I'm saying? Trying to be all on cameras. They just put their shit down.
Right,
yeah.
Dr. Dre came and reinvented rap from a West Coast standpoint, and took that rock and roll energy that the East Coast had and took it somewhere way else. And then Suge Knight came along and got with Dre, and they went and got the money they're supposed to get, the position and the company. So they, now they got they own the company and own their end of the business, and it's like everybody can look at them and be inspired, because it's just Suge Knight, just a street nigga with all that energy, that raw energy and street smarts, you know, and took those smarts and beat everybody at their own game. So I can't say much about Death Row Records, Dre and Suge Knight, except, you know, I'm on their dick.
Corrupt and Daz is the dog pound group rappers, you know what I'm saying? They stepping out on the front to maintain and represent the whole clique as far as rap-wise.
they voice, they're the voices out there, you know what I'm saying? They are soldiers out there on the front line representing, speaking the real for us. I'm Snoop Dogg, I represent, what I represent is the whole dog pound is one, but we all is one. It ain't no such sections as, okay, you niggas run like this, nigga, we all one, we all family. Niggas just got different titles and different job duties, but we all have them.
What would you do if you could fuck with my crew?
You can get with the dog pound. Everybody wants to be your dog pound gangster.
Snoop Dogg, baby, DPG, I know I your love is the one they
said. Black hey, ass, ass. Hey,
you them niggas straight said that I bit they shit in.
Yeah.
What's up, big guy? I see you all in the motherfucking calendar, cuz.
What's up,
cuz? Calendar tight.
What's up, Smoke?
I said, that's Nate Dogg. What the fuck? Everybody in the dog pound got equal criticism, like, meaning from the youngest to the oldest. If the youngest was to say, dog, that shit ain't hitting, change that shit, he got that love to make a nigga change it. I'm just saying, as far as the respect of everybody in the dog pound, that's what we need to address. There ain't no such thing as a leader or, you know, nigga get all the praises. Nigga, we all individuals. We all treated as men. It's, you know what I'm saying? On that page with respect. Everybody get that same respect.
Dog pound, how y'all
DP, DP, DPG, DP, DP, DPG.
I oughta start dipping, sipping on that SD gets me to tripping. I don't slip, I bang.
With that mad ass dog pound gang, it's a DPG thing. Come up from the SC. You wanna test me? Let's see if you'll survive 45 times. Like a hollow boy headed for your dome. Take a couple steps, turn around and it's on you. Couldn't withstand the murderous mental. I subdue and then take two to your temp win. When I call, all I call from what's written. Niggas collapsing when the straps is spitting. Look, this is how it's done. 1, 2, 3. See, it's sort of just for good. Load the pump, corrupts the kingpin of the click. Little is G with the biggest G.
Shit, yeah. The motherfucker better recognize. With the twist of my wrist like OJ, you all die.
They all die.
I stack a motherfuckers like a bone. Don't be the shit, I'm on a microphone. Ever since I was born, not to ever love a B.I.G. Shirt gang, not the game. That's why we all the best to see. Many began to style minute after minute. But as soon as you did it, I smelt your ass shit.
Yeah. Motherfuckers, now what would you do?
If you could fuck with me or my crew.
But you can't, so don't even think about stepping in the motherfucking
field. What would you do if you could fuck with me or my crew?
But you can't, so don't even think about stepping in the motherfucking hey.
You think you can rap, you come around here with all that bullshit thinking that Death Row, you know what I'm saying, or they can't really root, woo, woo. I serve them off the top. They get served.
Like the West Coast, they tell a story that East Coast don't go through. You know what I'm saying? You have your shootings out here, your killings, your wildness, your buck wild, all this. But out there, it's a different mentality. You know what I'm saying? It's a whole different mentality. And a lot of people, when they first start hearing West Coast groups from out here, they thought, oh, they just exaggerating. It can't be that bad out there. Until you go out there and you see what's going on out there.
Any more times of this humiliation? How many more bouts do we have to lose while we fight for our rights in this nation that we supposed to have since birth? But the brakes on the bricks get worse, so it's jail first. And that's all they offer us. Ain't that right, Mr. Officer?
The chain remains, the chain remains, the chain remains, the chain remains.
But you know, it's all founded around here. You know, this like, you look up there, this William and North 14th. Down there, 15th Street, right, this block here is where Vin grew up.
Seven kids lived in a two-bedroom house, you know? Two-bedroom apartment.
And to those other MCs, naughty by nature, four nigga, please. We just took the time to form three companies, now the whole industry awaits the new recital. I take your favorite idol, I crumple up the title in the face, cause I'm fed up with that same old crap. Lack of developing your crew, that's why your stage shows white. So let the sleeping and the assuming, I can't hear myself.
We really started sticking every day, like around the 8th and 9th grade.
Yeah.
So that's when we really just formed up. Like back in the New Style days when we first formed the New Style group.
This is
This is new style.
It's the house where it all started, the headquarters. You might remember this house from Ghetto Bastard, Everything's Gonna Be All Right video. It's KG's home. This is the Gist family house. And this is where it all started. We was making noise all up in K room, Miss Gist and Mr. Gist up there just letting us do our thing, feeling our vibes and everything that came up from way back in the days with the new style era, all that, you know what I'm saying, came from in this house. All the crates of records, the beat machines. We wrote OPP in that house right there. Came up with the whole concept, the idea around it and everything. So this is why we love this and ain't leaving this for nothing. You know what I'm saying? This is the foundation here. This is what started it all. Yeah, still there. I ain't going nowhere. It's all right here. It's all good in the hood. All good in the hood.
Through hip hop, that's really like the only way to let, you know, the rest of the country know what's going on, like over in your own neighborhood or whatever. Or basically, what we talk about on the record is we talking about about our neighborhood. We speaking for the people around there. It's not like we just going on records and cursing or talking this or talking that. It's a message in every record.
They go L-Town Finest right there. Police alert. And it's song. Hey!
You know, when they say fuck the police, it doesn't mean that they hate the police. It means that there's a resentment in the community and that maybe the police themselves.
Yeah, we went to 92 to beat, kicking it, you know what I'm saying, for like 2 hours. I just got off a flight 5 hours from Jersey. Get there, get off, do the interview 2.5 hours, leave, you know what I'm saying? Me and Havoc just kicking it, you know what I'm saying? Listening to tapes, jamming, cooling. Look in the rear view, whoop, whoop, pulled over. Like, what's up? They come, get out the car. One, you on the driver. Park, take out the key, get out. This and that and the other. You next. Get out, this and that. Looking at me, where you from? What gang you in? What you doing out this? What is this and that the other? Where you? I'm like, we just come from the radio station. Radio station, what radio station? 92 to beat. People riding by honking. Hey. So then that's when they really calm down. Before we got frisked. You know what I'm saying? My nuts all touched by some nigga. You know what I'm saying? Like that. That shit was, they just played us out. It just fucked up the whole night. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Fucked up the whole vibe.
So they made y'all get out the car.
Out the car. Interlock your fingers behind your head. You know what I'm saying? People riding by. You just, you know what I'm saying? Just got off the radio station giving advice. I was looking for some advice after that shit.
Even when in Texas, we don't get trooping. That's when I find the baddest bros in Houston boosted. Break down, fill the party.
And then 12 bars after that, let me hear my man. I'm saying, well, you just squeeze it to 12. We'll just do some dissecting.
Number one, clap your hands this evening.
No, it should be, yeah, it's all right. Clap your hands this evening.
He should be coming in right here. Turn me up a little bit up in my shits. Check it out, I gotta hear myself. I gotta release tension. Come again, I got to mention. Freestyle, free flow, off the dome, once again, you know. Now here we go. Falling through the earth with a burst first for ya. Clapping your hands, now we must say a rah, for sure. But I am still thirsty, oh mercy, it's worthy. Come firsty, oh curse me, it's Jersey.
If you really wanna find out what's going on in the hood, you really wanna find out what's going on in the ghettos, all you have to do is tune into hip hop.
Naughty by Nature is nothing without, you know, 18th Street, without East Orange, without Ill Town. Ill Town created us, we are Ill Town. We're just products of Ill Town, and that's basically what we represent.
This is how we do it here. I got barbarians to guard me in the club that part we went. Abroad got thrown like my barn up and thrown and get thrown abroad. A brim is broke to the back. I'm bad and brave for praise for both. The boots worth the burnt bamboo, shake the loot. Blowing up brain cells, boom! Like assume the same suit, fuck that fly shit. With the flavor, cause shy kids, I see me Suzuki, but still my socket. Whip that high quick, if you slack with blood clutch and blood quick. You ain't rolling if I take it, what's your ride say? What's some nice shit? Cause nigga, snatch shit like the youngsters about to take you on some hip hop ride shit.
Dodo.
Peace, how you feeling?
Yeah,
let's get down here.
Yeah.
True.
take the show, you know?
Yeah, I'm not.
Then we...
Yeah, my fault.
That's fine. What's that?
Sorry.
We heard that Bhutan is sort of like a movement, and there's like 150 members all together, and you have some sort of new...
I got an answer for that. Wu-Tang Clan rocks the world. Alright, Wu-Tang Clan rocks the world. We gonna have Wu-Tang out here as soon as we us being out here for these little 3 days right here. By the time we leave, we gonna have like 50 Wu-Tang members here. You know what I'm saying? And it's gonna keep spreading. I mean, our numbers grow every day.
Don to natta hanabi da kirei da na oshi hitotsu nai kono saite na tokyo no yozora megake tsuba hakeba odeko ni hit sokode ikku hineri da sou de new lyric my tension wa sagari panashi chotto kidotte tsubuyaite mika boshi mimi ake chiteki sun ja ne kakuratte mika matta yakke zakke I'm the mad Mr. Drunk.
1, 2, 3.
Wu-Tang, they was always like the bad guys in the flicks, but with a cause. So we like the bad guys in the industry with a cause, you know what I'm saying?
Smoking Wu's at 16, running up big gates, doing hits for high stakes. You know what I'm saying?
We like to get that money, boy.
Anything.
Anything it take to live a better life, we deserve to get that money. Anything. Positive, negative, we just all about getting there, getting out.
Y'all doing, yo, man, it's like, man, we live the life, man, there's so much rough shit, man. You know what I'm saying? It's like a nigga grew up in a three-bedroom apartment, right, with like 16 niggas in there, man. You know what I'm saying? Some nights you couldn't have nothing to eat, man. I mean, my mom's at the time, man, used to put vegetables on a plate with no meat.
Now, young people, you see a lot of people who have the dread, you know, go to the tanning shop, get, you know, dark skin. That's a part of culture, I think, you know, we try to, you know, catch up with, you know.
Thanks so much, Ghostface.
You know what I'm saying? Yo, you know what I'm saying? I get loves all over the planet, wherever I walks, planet Earth, you know what I'm saying?
I think hip-hop artists is more active, you know. They have more curiosity, they want to go out, you know. But I think that the media has such wrong information, you know, putting a lot of image of the artists. When artists get here, it's just different, you know. They are much more nicer.
It don't really do nothing for your thoughts and shit. But when I smoke some headbanger boogie, some of that fucking Hawaiian shit and all that other good shit, I be writing super crazy ill bongs.
But a lot of brothers in the industry smoke weed. So that's what make brothers feel like, that's what makes the other motherfuckers feel like, yo, it's something that gotta be together or whatever, man. That's just how we come into this shit, man. We been smoking weed, we gonna keep it like that.
Yeah, yeah.
Man.
I want to smoke, look.
Lots of men. Trust me.
Four pieces.
You got two right there.
Yeah.
Just on the wall over there, man. You don't want to stick over there.
Check this out. Nigga, get a haircut. Real bad. And I can't get
Cultue.
Method Man!
Sleepy Hollow, in fact, I'm a hard act to follow. I dealt with no-no, bone guard coming on through niggas. It's like, oh my God, not you.
Got everything that any other ghetto got. Snitches, stank bitches. We got, oh man, brothers is going through the struggle everywhere, man. But where I'm from, Park Hill, I can tell you about Park Hill. Park Hill like this to me, man. You come out on the block, you never know what the fuck's gonna happen. Anything can happen, like, you can play. You can play ball all fucking day, get sweaty and shit, then later on
man,
that night.
Man, kill that shit, man.
What?
You know what I'm saying? Say that. Nobody want to hear that shit.
Y'all niggas is still worthless, boy. Y'all been fucking playing me for this whole fucking shit just cause the fucking camera's on. Y'all cut that shit out, man.
My mom sending me to school. You know what I'm saying? I never got, couldn't really get fresh and shit. Everybody get fresh for Easter and all that shit. Nigga had like 2 pair of pants and shit. I gotta wear 1 pair like 2 or 3 times straight or whatever, then change to the next one or whatever and shit.
Yo, I'ma say that shit.
I don't give a fuck. I'll be do that shit any other motherfucking time.
I'm saying like this, y'all brothers.
I don't give a fuck who's around.
Check this out. Whenever it come down this camera shit, y'all niggas get on some bullshit.
Yo, God, take it's
it.
Like this.
Now I'm taking it back to Arsenio.
God,
we
fuck,
is at
fuck,
no, fuck,
fuck
that.
Fuck
no, 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 no.
What?
No, 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 no. My name was on the paper to say the rhyme or whatever, right? Right?
So
was
what?
It? Was it? Or was it not? Niggas hurt my feelings on some. That nigga, fuck that. How come he always got
that's
to do
right.
Blasey Blah and this and that? But listen,
what?
We was in London. My name was on the paper on some Method Man and 3 other band members do the interviews.
Yeah.
I ain't hear nobody. Why that nigga got to do all that? No,
fuck
niggas
all that
stayed
shit.
In their beds, slept while I went to the radio station by
right.
my fucking self.
Went
I went up to RCA to Germany
that's
by
mother,
myself.
You right.
You went there 3
so
motherfucking
what?
Other
what?
Times. Mike.
You don't know what you talking about. You don't know what you talking about. Your ass sat in the fucking radio station. In the other side on the fucking phone talking to
like
some
this,
hoe
man.
While
I'm
we in there doing
fucking
some
goddamn
fucking
I'm
shit.
I'm trying to get my shit, nigga.
What
fuck
shit?
You talking about? My
what
motherfucking shit? Church, nigga, still out fucking London. Bitch ass motherfucker.
You trying to get your shirt.
That's right, motherfucker.
While we was in there busting our ass, and you got paid to, on the phone.
So what?
Trying
I did my interviews,
shirt.
Nigga. When I was doing the interviews, who was doing all the fucking talking? You was, as usual. You fucking sit up there and talk,
because
talk,
because look
talk,
at the
talk,
asses
talk,
you
talk,
give.
Talk,
look at
talk,
the asses
talk.
You give.
She ain't got no drawers
wait,
on,
Nick.
Huh? None. This nigga know, too.
Fuck all the cosmetic rap shit.
Y'all niggas want the pain?
Yo, what the fuckers? Want the pain?
Niggas don't want the pain.
Y'all niggas don't want it.
If y'all want the pain, let me hear you say hell yeah.
I got you, baby.
Say hell yeah. Say fuck yeah. Say shit yeah. Just make sure my mic is all the way up. If y'all with me, everybody sing along.
I came to bring the pain,
hardcore for the brain. Let's go inside my ass to play. Find out my mental, based on instrumental. Wreck it,
so I can write monumental.
Right there, I'm not the king. My niggas is DK, I'll stick them on the green.
Check it,
just out deep and shit. Get deep as the pit. And brothers in that pit,
accept it.
In your cross, pull up, close your cross, over. And got all of these cross down. Nigga get torn to the side, and on the dark side of the
wall.
Of course it's the method,
man from the Wu-Tang Clan.
I'll be hectic, they're coming for the head,
leave a jacket.
Fuck it, two tears in a bucket, nigga want the rocket. Bustin' on me, bro,
where was it?
Sound is fuck well,
bet the man on some shit.
Pull a nigga fast,
I'm sick,
this ain't crazy. Try to live,
Jay-Z,
all the fucking money I got born.
Is it real, sir?
Is it really real, sir?
Let me know it's real, sir.
If it really real.
Nigga.
Yo, get your black ass back up here, man.
Hey, yo, Ma, let's smoke him out, Ma. Smoke him out. Smoke him out.
Now you gonna fuck around and get Vic like that. Word up.
Yo, Ma, smoke him out. Yo, Ma.
Yo, smoke check it out. Yo, hundreds of niggas. Yo, hundreds of niggas, check it out.
Yo, Ma, major announcement, y'all. Check it out. Next on stage, live. Coming at your fucking dome.
World up.
The pioneers of this shit. Y'all niggas show y'all love. But run, DMC.
It was dazing, man. That's we were dazing. We don't remember like the first few years of our career. It was just big. We was just going.
God's plan.
God's plan. We didn't. We didn't even see it. We was dazing.
The blessing overtook us. We didn't overtake it. It just came and like engulfed us and grabbed us and took us to stardom, and that was it.
I ain't fucking with you. This man D used to come and they had record ideas and all that, and I just finished school. And I said finished school thinking I ain't gonna fuck with him, nigga's gonna be up. And then he, you know, people around me start telling me, you know, fuck with your brother, because he's right with his shit, and fuck with DMC, because he's right. And so it came together, and then Jay came along, and they became Run DMC.
To us, they like the George Clintons to our parents. And, you know what I'm saying? Like, they, when we were little and not even in the game, in the rap, just more just fans of all the whole thing, they were like the gods of the rap. They, like, took it to that next level that made hip-hop more mainstream and out there. You know what I'm saying? They took it to the level where it could be as commercial as it is today. So if you diss running them, man, you dissing hip-hop.
Names was always L, coming up with names. And then Russell called and said, the name of your group is going to be Run DMC. But see, now, right now, when I'm saying that, it sounds deaf, because Run DMC is the household word. It sounds, oh, Run DMC. But imagine that name never existed on the earth. And you're standing there, and your manager calls and say, the name of your group is going to be Run DMC.
He knows his name was D to MC, and Run was DJ Run, the son of Curtis Blow. So that's what it was, DJ Run and D to MC, DMC. And that's so, it was easy to Run DMC.
I just seen Joe's face cringe. And then he said, here, take the phone. I'm like, what? He gave me the phone. He said, D, the name of the group is Run DMC. And I still remember that day in Larry Attic. I was standing there, and he said, Run DMC. And it was the worst, stupidest thing I ever heard. And
at that time, it was most important to us to do shit that was very simple and real.
And early in our career, it was always something like that going on. Russell, you're trying to ruin us. They're trying to ruin us. They're trying to ruin us. Even with Rockbox, when they put the guitars on it, oh, they're trying to ruin us.
Our whole thing was, let's try to be real. And the realest thing that you could do was just put a drum beat with nothing but a drum beat. So a record like Suck MC, and also loud, you know. And so we wanted guitars, because we used to always scratch guitars, but not scratch guitar riffs, just the noise. You know, that whole, you know, you cut the beat and you give it dynamics. And that was loud shit.
We was coming up, man, rap was everything. Rap was, if you, you know, you go to school, you go to high school, you go to the cafeteria, we beating on the tables and the kid like runners running his mouth all the time. You go everywhere. Anytime I was a DJ, anytime I bring my turntables out in the park, it'd be 15, at least 10 of them MCs from the neighborhood that were actually almost near fist fight with the mic. You know, it was just like they had to have the mic. It was like a drug or something.
Got love for them niggas, period. Just from being in the game. I mean, I grew up to that shit. When my mom got me a radio for Christmas, she got me a Fat Boys tape and a Run DMC tape. That's all I had.
I'ma slow it down on the real ill B-boy. Catch your heart from back in the day jam and bug your whole life out, make you go home, smack yourself in the back of the head. Put your hands up like this. We gonna go from side to side. Everybody that's with old school hip hop and know about Run DMC from way back and know we gonna do, you don't even know what we gonna do next. We got so many hits. Put your hands in there, everybody, like this.
We gonna reach for the sky.
We gonna do it like this. What's my name? What's my name?
Run.
What's my name?
Run.
What'd you say?
Run.
That's cool. Now, put your hands back in there. Come on, don't front on a nigga. We gonna go from side to side on a real slow tip, and everybody gotta repeat after me real loud. Over there too, y'all peeps. Oh, crazy like, on the real old school tip. I say,
party people. Your dreams have now been fulfilled. Get out your seats and let's go. Just rough, and more than tough, and when it comes to rhymes, we got enough, though.
It's not that, y'all, don't stop, the top, together,
forever, together, Run DMC, and we're tougher than leather, we make it, and break it, and snatch it, and take it, the deal for real, we can never be fake. I'm chilling, it's cool, and I'm the king that's ruling.
Cause it's easy to be. Beat making, never faking, chilling all of the time. Ball playing, rhyme saying, and I keep mine.
No way to rock me, rock the way to stop me.
Stop it.
Seems quite shocking.
Shocking.
Those that mock me. And that's not all. MCs have to go. Pray and play for my time fall. But I'm not running.
Running.
I'm just stunning.
Stunning.
Smart, not stupid, cause I'm so cunning.
Cunning.
Seems regretting.
Ready.
I'm upsetting.
Not inside of it.
Old school is groups that made a difference in hip-hop pre-recording.
There were a whole slew of groups, underground groups. We call them local bands that were known just around in New York City, like Kool Herc, Bambada, Grandmaster Flash.
Mario.
You can't forget DJ Hollywood.
Mario.
Eddie Cheever, Love Buck Star.
Right. But check this out.
Wait a minute.
Cold Crush.
But the one that you can't forget, DJ Hollywood, and a lot of brothers do be doing forget, yeah, DJ Hollywood. When you're talking about old school, didn't make a record and making a difference, for me, nobody commanded a crowd better than DJ Hollywood. You know what I'm saying? And not get on wax.
So that's important. He's the first nigga to say hip hop. And Big Bang Hank was a fake Hollywood, and he know it. And everybody knows that everybody who came after Hollywood, when it used to be the House of Joy and Fun Club 371, it was DJ Hollywood with the headliner.
Before we made our first records, we were rapping 5 and 6 years in the clubs, in the block parties, on the streets. You know what I'm saying? Run used to go around to every block party in Queens and rock on the microphone. So he had the experience to handling an audience.
You go to the gym, say Russell Simmons, he'll throw a party. You go there, Grandmaster Flash, Furious Five performing, DJ Hollywood. Somebody will sneak a tape in or somebody will get a tape up in the DJ booth and you make the tape. You tape the show, bring it out in the street, sell it $6 to $10. A lot of tapes were sold like that. My first tape I brought was the Cold Crush tape, $6. I paid for it, and it was like an album to me.
Rap has always been here for many years. When God talked to Moses and any of the prophets, he was rapping with them. If you look at the 30s and the 20s, with Cab Calloway, Hotty Hotty Outta Ho, with the bebop, they was also having their style of rap. If you look at the dozens, when you talk about your mama or your papa, that was dealing with rap.
Who are the real creators of hip hop is a toss up between the bourgeoisie disco hip hoppers and the hardcore b-boy hip hoppers of the Bronx.
This is some trivia for y'all. What MC made up the terminology, yes, yes, y'all?
Left
Eye. Nope.
No. Swanee.
Nope.
You tell us, oh great one.
And Raheem there, boy.
Kid Creole.
And Kid Creole.
That's right. He made up the terminology, yes, yeah, yes, right. Y'all.
About,
he made that up.
Just to bridge from rhyme to rhyme. Once I said a rhyme, in order to get to the next rhyme, yes, yes, y'all.
Every
beat,
MC that freak, ever
y'all.
Said a rhyme said, yes, yes, y'all. Y'all owe this boy money. He wanted money.
Everybody.
All right. You can send me checks.
Exciting day in my life, to this day still, it got to be another one coming, it got to be another one coming as big as that, because I've been telling this same story forever, was being at the Garden in 87, and it was sold out, 20,000 people.
They came to the Garden full of confidence with hot records, and they came and did their thing. Remember, Run walking on the stage and talk about, they wouldn't let him in at first, he said, I beg your pardon, but this is my motherfucking Garden.
Yeah, I talked about, okay, I beg your pardon, but this is my Emma effing Garden, and I came out, you know, did my thing. But the L part about it was that I told everybody to put their Adidas sneaker in the air.
They pull up a sneaker and said, my Adidas.
And it was like 20,000 people took their sneakers off and put it in the air. We was up to like 3 million albums then. I was already excited about that, being up to 3 million albums. And I said, yo, everybody put your sneaker in the air, and everybody had no shoestrings in them, so it was easy to take them off. So they take the sneaker off and they put it in the air, and the guy from Adidas, the representative, when I got off stage, he told me that I was gonna have my own line of Adidas sneakers.
Now check this out. Throw that back over there. We gonna get busy. I'm ready to go to the next level. Y'all ready to go to the next level? We gonna do it like this. D, what's this right here?
Yo, this is my black shirt. You mess around and get hurt.
What's this under there?
Yo, this is my black belt. I whip them C's and I give them whelps.
What's this on your legs?
Yo, these my black pants. I beat you down if I get the chance.
Do me one favor.
What?
What the fuck are these, man? I go to Clement, my Adidas and D, both as can be. We make a mean team, my Adidas and me. We get around
together,
we're down
forever.
And I won't be hot when wanting bad weather. My Adidas,
everybody,
come on. What's the name of this song? Now throw your hands in the air. Throw your hands in the air.
What's up?
Adidas, standing on 2 feet street. Funky red,
and yeah.
Go on my feet with no shoestring.
Get some real niggas. Who your nephew in here?
Huh? Let right there.
Who?
Right there, not Jamel.
What's up, nigga?
Chris.
What's going on? What's up, man?
Jay, he gonna play with us. He's good.
Yeah?
So do y'all got 5 good players?
Yeah, we got 5.
We gonna be real.
Damn, this nigga ain't on my squad?
It's kinda easy when you listen to the G-Dub sound. Pioneer.
got the sound for your ass, and it's easy to see that this DJ be
kinda easy when you listen to the G-Dub sound. Well, I would even say the word easy, you know what I'm saying? When you say easy, you think of easy listening. This music is ill. But what makes it the most interesting to me about the whole thing is he's Dr. Dre's little brother. That takes my mind to a whole nother realm when I think. So Dr. Dre's selling millions, and you were supposed to have Snoop, is from what I understand. Snoop was your man, so Dre took him and put him out, and you waited in the boondocks.
You can tell he
and now they gotta give him
his.
Summer 92, you know. It was about 20 guys staying at my house at the time. You know, Snoop, Warren, all the guys that were on the Chronic that were involved in that album. And when I would stop in the studio, they would go down there and start, you know, fucking around with the drum machines and shit, you know, had the shit cranking all night, learning the shit, you know. I would come in and show him a few things every now and then, but he basically picked it up on his own, you know. And that's like I was telling you, if I'd have known the motherfucker was gonna be 2 million copies a couple of years later, I'd have been down there a little bit more, you know.
You could tell that the same person was making.
That a funny sound.
Same person was not the only the sound was playing it.
The snare, that the drum machine.
It was the same thing going on. You know what I'm saying? It's just like you and your brother. You know. That's how people were saying. How are you gonna have Russell Simmons managing all these people and Run being down? It's the main rapper.
Hey, I am worried about how Dre is Warren G's older brother, and yeah. I got Russell doing what he do.
There you go.
He had developed his own style. He didn't use none of the shit that I do, you know, none of my sounds or none of that shit. He just came out and did his own thing, came up with his own shit, which is dope.
Excuse me!
I don't know, he came down here last year, and I met him last year. Just wanted to see if he still remember me. Shit, just all of the beat, lyrics. I've always listened to it. You know, white people getting into it.
You got some zigzags?
Huh?
You got some zigzags? Oh, did they hear me say that?
Let me take you on a trip with the Jeep, but we bump still got the shit bumping in our trunk. Now recognize game in your face. I touch on the base, I'm a passion to my niggas, so don't play for a second. Let me wreck shop. It's rainy yet, still dropping rhymes non-stop. But I'm a passion to the flow to my girl named Nev Love. Show them how you do it when you come.
Yeah, love, high and above all the rest. Watch out, because I got stress on my chest. I'm the best at what I do, because I rap with the crew. G-Bone. When I started out the line, you don't know me, even if you do. I'ma break it down, because I thought you knew. Strictly new when I step, strut. I move my little bun, brainiac in the house. Tip, no one.
Let me get a WAP. And a, what's the biggest nuggets you got?
9.
2 9 piece. 2 large fries.
A fat apple pie.
I wish we could. A lemon pie.
A medium coke. Some fries.
Ain't got no hash browns, dude.
Not yet.
Some onion rings.
A apple pie.
And a whopper.
Oh, man. And a whopper with cheese.
It's down there, though. It's gonna stay down there,
because
I ain't taking out no more of my stuff.
Ooh, I'm fixing
grub. I see.
I I do want vegetables, but I'm subject to Burger King every day of my life. But I have to make this work because I am a phenomenal woman. Maya Angelou.
Day two.
How many days to go?
Too many.
Hey, bro, where are you going? You forgot your application.
Oh, man. I got a real job.
If you ain't in the house, you was in the shack. Fire up the sack. B.I.G's greatest hits. B.I.G.
Stand back, give me some room, because when this is over,
seven dice.
I'ma need a broom.
Boy, you don't need a broom.
Gotta keep the bus clean. We ain't had no dirty bus. I always do this. See, most niggas don't clean that bus up. I clean my shit up. I hate a dirty bus.
He passed three times in a row. And then I bet with him. He passed three times in a row. But then he rolled a 9 for his point, and we bet it. Then homeboy said, let's bet 5 and 9 too.
We picked up on that money.
Nigga, I bet on the five. I picked up.
I wish niggas quit conversating over the money. I know that. I know his motherfucking point, nigga. I know what the hell I bet it. Hello?
Conjunction, yeah. What's my function? Yeah. I'm looking up tracks so that niggas can function. Uh-huh. It's not Pete Rock or that nigga Dr. Dre. It's this motherfucking nigga from around the way. The one that brings you styles on times. That's why so far define me. Conduction and construction when I bust. Choo-choo busters. Yeah. It's a must when I bust, when I bust. I gotta come correct. The R to the E to the SBA architect. Yep, nigga, no, I'm not tweaking. Yeah. It's one of the 16 minds that I'm spitting. The W-A, the double R, the E into the A-B-C-D-E-F to the motherfucking G. Yeah. Ooh, shit, as I flex, I rex, I check. The what's next?
All right, start again from the top. Slick Rick.
Slick Rick. Hey, Young World.
Young World.
Right, Children's Story.
Children's Story.
Teenage Love.
Teenage Love.
I'll take New York.
Okay.
Okay, for third base, I have gas
tank.
That pays to the
end.
And Pop goes the weasel.
You hear a lot of stuff about Russell. You hear from every direction it is, but for as Russell come from me, I look at Russell as whoever wanna deny it, don't wanna give him his props, they gotta give it to him. Russell Simmons made the way for if it's Suge, if it's Dre, if it's anybody in the hip hop business because he started it.
What LL Cool J?
LL Cool J, I have.
Listen, John.
I need a beat. Around the way, girl. I'm a sad. Backseat of my Jeep. I'm bad. And radio.
What the fuck? Is somebody high? That's fucking wrong. Where's, that list is crazy. What? I want to kill Kathy.
In 1984, I had sent a tape into this guy named Rick Rubin. He was the guy who gave me my break. Everybody knows him. And he introduced me to Russell at Russell's office. He had a small office down on Broadway. Me and Rick played a record for him called I Need a Beat. And he really liked that record. So what happened was instead of them taking that record and going to a distributor and trying to get it distributed and having problems with the money, they decided to form an independent company called Def Jam and put that record out.
Because I know he'd be dropping a lot of knowledge to his artists, you know what I'm saying? Because he got a lot of artists.
And Russell definitely knows how to make money. That's all I want to do is sit down and let's ask him questions about how I can make money. Let me know everything I could do to make a million, Russ, because I know you know what to do.
How much is payroll? How much is all that shit equal up? Look, that's your problem, right? I mean, that's my problem, but you're working on it.
It started out with, you know, tall, skinny bitches, like I was in high school. Looking at magazines and saying that she's fine, I want to meet this hoe. Then the next thing I know, I've been hanging out at all the parties where you get one party and it'd be 60 girls, they all be 6 feet and fine. So that's, you know, and I guess no niggas can be mad at going there. Then after that, I met the clients and all the people who run all the department stores and buy all the clothes. And then I started looking at the fabrics and the clothes, the way they were making them, and I started, you know, seeing how niggas, you know, hip-hop niggas influence all the shit that they try to do anyway. You know, I'd see Chanel, I go to Chanel show, and Karl Lagerfeld got a big gold chain around a bitch neck. I was like, how fake is that, you know? Fat Farm became like a hobby, you know, and I started making clothes. And I looked at the fabrics that and started to really understand the business through all the designers and the editors and the models. I started really, it became a real serious hobby. And that hobby became more serious as we put more money into it. Let me tell you something, when I first started hanging out with these tall girls, they wasn't playing hip-hop music in the parties. I used to feel like, you know what I'm saying, I had to have a reason to be up in that spot besides for some tall bitch. Because my job is to get money. And I didn't mean bitch like, I mean worldly, sophisticated, independent, badass bitch, you know. The kind of hoes every man want to marry.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So I didn't want to say it like, bitch, you know, because I know people will be watching this who ain't hip-hop and might not understand when I say bitch, I mean bad bitch. You know, super bitch, you know, super powerful, independent, successful bitch.
Right.
Not like no necessarily, not at all derogatory in no way, you know what I'm saying? Because I love women, I can't sympathize with all the rappers be talking, they hate them hoes, all that. I love girls.
Thank you, Daddy.
Hello?
Hey, who got some gangsta shit?
Niggas.
You got some gangsta shit.
Fuck that shit. Who got some gangsta shit?
You got some gangsta shit.
Sing it. Who got some gangsta shit?
You got some gangsta
shit. Fuck
that shit.
Who got some gangsta shit?
You got some gangsta shit.
You know all my niggas and my bitches. Wave your motherfucking hands in the air.
Give it up
to all my bitches. Wave your motherfucking hands in the air.
Come on, yeah.
You don't give a fuck like you don't give a fuck. Your motherfucking hands in the air.
Yeah. Put this dance on the floor. D.O. Double G, nigga. See these other fools, but you can't see that shit.
Come on, who am I?
Yeah.
Do or die.
That's right, that's right.
So slow your roll, I'm in control like Janet. The local 21-year-old nigga that's on the planet. Take it for granted if you wanna. Cause I'm gonna grab my strap and clear the phone up.
All the Nooski brothers, they ain't thinking about what a crowd is going to, how a crowd is going to react to their song, or how somebody's going to come see their show and have fun. That's why right now, none of them brothers could go on tour, whereas everybody here went on big tours, you know,
and
30 cities tours. They can't go on tour because don't nobody want the rap in the building.
You don't know what it's like to go platinum and sit home.
You have new guys who come out, they go platinum. They've never seen 20,000 people.
That's
or 10,000
right.
People, or 1,000 people, or 100 people.
The difference between what we did and what they doing now, it was a form of entertainment. When you came into concert and you seen, like if you see a Run DMC show, or you see a Houdini show, or you see a Curtis Blow show, you seeing a show. You see a Grandmaster Flash show, you seeing a show, you see these boys right now, you see just a brother out on stage. And that ain't pulling no weight.
Back in the day, 1976, when I started rapping, I was in a group called Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. And even though like things were rugged and things were tough, we felt like there was an opportunity for us to be successful. So people would make raps that are different from today. Like people would make raps, like I made a record called Getting Money. Everything's funny when you're getting money. Because I felt like there was an opportunity to get money. Now rappers are making smash hits like Bring the Pain. Because people feel like they're growing up in a time where there's no system for them to figure out how to get money. So I think that I was born in 1960, so I might have been the last generation of the affirmative action rap group. And now you got Reaganomic rap groups. And Reaganomics took away after school programs, took away summer jobs, took away student loans. So you got a whole generation of rappers who are growing up under the auspices of Generation X, who grew up with no hope, and all they see is pain.
Living up to what you see on records, it's all entertainment. Anybody in their fucking right mind know you could talk about shooting somebody on the record, but motherfucker ain't finna really go out there and do it unless you just stupid. You know what I'm saying? It's entertainment, you know? We make records, it's entertainment. That's all it is. This is like our fucking jobs, you know?
There'd be always one motherfucker that'll do some shit, like throw some shit on stage. I remember, man, this nigga threw some shit on stage, man. And you know, we roll with the fort. Niggas just like zoomed in, whoop. Right off the stage, niggas just whipped his ass right the fuck out the arena, came back on, we just finished the show and shit. Like, it used to pop off like that often, be like, nigga, fuck them niggas. And then you turn around like, what, they all...
Yeah, like they
and then we be like, who said that shit? Then the whole crowd be like, him.
Yo, we gotta line these niggas up, son.
Line these niggas up.
Yo, what the fuck, man? Line them the fuck up. What the fuck?
No need for that, just grab the fuck that's right. Yeah. The pocket that's fat, take us to his back. What is born?
I was hungry.
And don't fake no move. What? Treat him like boxes, stick and move, stick and move.
Besides selling the records, you know, artists get their money from their shows. You got a tight-ass show, niggas don't want to see you. So me and Puff just tried to make the tightest show we could for me.
He makes Biggie Smalls and Craig Mack Flavor in Your Ear. All those records are his. I had to call him my protege, but he's selling more records than me right now. So I got a new name for the nigga now.
Bad Boy Entertainment, you know what I'm saying? We done did Mary J. Blige, Jodeci when I was at Uptown, Fallen Sea, Heavy D. Now we got the Notorious Big, Craig Mack, a lot of new acts coming out. This stuff on TLC, Pebble. Trying to make some noise, a New York black company. Bad Boys for Life, you know what I'm saying?
Anything we could do to get the crowd crazy, anything we could do, we'd just do it. If it wasn't such a big nigga, I'd have been jumping in the crowd too. But I ain't really with that extracurricular shit.
I've listened to Juicy. I was a part of Juicy. And Big Papa. Big Papa I like.
The birds at y'all at. Yeah. Throw your motherfucking hands up. Yeah. Give them throw your motherfucking hands up.
What's up, baby?
Yeah. Throw your motherfucking hands up.
The place with style and grace, allow me to make your lyrical dishes in your bushes. Who rock grooves and make moves with all the mommies?
The back of the club,
sipping my wet is where you find me.
The back of the club,
like it holds my crew behind me. Mad question asking, blood blasting, music blasting.
Yeah,
but I just can't quit because one of these
honeys,
Biggie,
got to creep with,
sleep with. A secret, why not?
Why not?
Why blow up my spot? Cause we both got cock.
Now check it.
I got more Mac than Craig and in the bed. Believe me, sweetie, got enough to feed the needy. No need to be greedy. Got mad friends with Benz and see those mother layers.
True fucking players.
Jump in the Rover and come over. Tell your friends you're in the GS3. Smoking chronic by the tree, cause
I love it when they call you Big Papa.
Throw your hands in the air if you're a true player.
I love it when they call you Big Papa.
To the honeys getting money playing. Like dummies,
I love it when they call you Big Papa.
You got my gun up in your waist, please don't shoot up the place.
Why?
Cause I see some ladies tonight and she'll be having what? What? Straight up, honey, really I'm asking. Most of these niggas think they be macking, they be acting. Who they attracting with that line?
What's your name? What's your sign?
Soon as he buy that wine,
I just creep up from behind.
They ask you what your interests are.
Who you be with?
Things that make you smile. What numbers to dial? You gon' be here for a while. I'ma call my crew,
you gon' call your crew.
We can rendezvous at the bar round two.
Plans to leave, throw the keys a little C's.
Pull a truck up front, roll up the next blunt. So we can steam all the way to the telly, go fill my belly. T-bone steak, cheese eggs and munchies.
That's right.
Conversate for a few views. Cause in a few, we gon' do what we can and do.
Ain't that right, boo?
To me, this is what hip-hop means. To write a rhyme, to just create, to have a microphone in your hand, and people in front of you, and for them to know that what you're saying is butter.
To me, hip-hop is a way of life. You know what I'm saying? It's what you wake up in the morning, and it's who you are, and it's representing what I am and what I feel inside.
Shit, hip-hop to me is way out. You know what I'm saying? It's like, just imagine, just look at all the fucking rappers out there, all the motherfuckers that's doing hip-hop music, and ask them what would they be doing if hip-hop never came around. You have a lot of dead motherfuckers, you have a lot of broke motherfuckers out there, because there's a lot of motherfuckers out there trying to get into hip-hop or already in hip-hop. You know what I'm saying? So it's a way out. It's fucking opportunity. You know what I'm saying? It's fucking big business.
The things nowadays that make me happiest, besides for the things I can buy, and the other shit that comes along with people's conventional idea what will make them happy. If I get a little paper and I could hire a nigga straight out of jail, somebody I grew up with, which we do all the time, friends we help, you know, and they become successful and they get this shit on, and I see that, or if I find an artist who just came out and a nigga's really hard working, really has a vision and believes in himself and is trying and trying, and suddenly I give this man a contract and he blows up, he's on the cover of Rolling Stone, and he gonna have little rich black babies, then that kind of thing means a lot to me now more than, you know, I didn't realize how much I appreciate seeing those things happen.
You in this shit now? The motherfuckers is telling you be here and there and that and there. You gotta establish a type of relationship with them where you know that they work for you. You don't work for them. You know what I'm saying? Everything that you do is for you. So every move that you make, make sure it's all out, because it's gonna matter in the end and shit.
But right now, rap is in its proper position, and it's opened doors. It opened doors for Run DMC, and Run DMC opened doors for people, and now the people that followed after Run DMC are still opening doors.
Hip hop is young pop culture. Like young pop culture with rock, like young pop culture with jazz, with blues. Young pop culture then was young black culture too. But the difference in hip hop is that young niggas is on the screen selling hip hop.
The reason why we make these records, we're crying out about our environment, we're crying out about our system. So now that, you know, you can appeal to 1.5 million, 2 million, 3 million people, telling them about your environment, after a point, it's not like you just take the benefits of it and just chill and live in a fat house or have fat cars and have all the women and never mind the rest of your environment. It's up to you, you know, your environment made you, now it's up to you to give back to the community.
Rap has become and a device of expression now, more or less. When we did it, we came out, it was just fun. You know, to this day, if we wasn't making records, we'd still have to get together and go in Hollis Park and throw a party. You know, I'd still be writing rhymes. If I was working at the post office, I'd have a book of rhymes. And today, rappers are just talking about what they're allowed to talk about, to express themselves musically.
You know what? There's one thing right now I want to say again. There's one thing I find amazing. That I've been here since 1982. I think before some little girl over there was even born. And they still call me out to do this movie and to go on last after the likes of Wu-Tang and Biggie Smalls and Craig Mack. And these kids were kids when I was doing this. And I'm just thankful, right, that I can still be able to come out here 12 years later and be able to do this and get support from people like y'all. So I want to ask y'all one question. I want everybody to get silent for me 1 minute in here. Everybody just shut up for a second. How many people out there down with the old school know about Run DMC? Put a hand in the air. If you're from the old school and you know from your heart and you seen Run DMC get busy before, put a hand in the air like this for all the old school from way, way back. And know about that. That's where all this new school come from, the old school. Now check this out. For all the true hip-hop fans out there, I'ma do a little something like this. This is my nigga right here. He go by the name of DMC. That's Jam Master J. We gonna do it like this. Now DJ Rock!
Yo, you gotta let him know. You gotta let him know.
You don't think they know?
I don't think they know, Cho.
I gotta take them back then. Hollis Crew style for sure. This is real. If it's ever been real, these turntables is on. Ain't no dat. Use a dat, you get this. It's either this or that. We'll do it like this. 1, 2, 1, 2. Now DJ runs. My name, Jam Master J, is his. He's the MC.
It's like that.
And that's the way it is.
Trying to fight fire with fire, you gotta fight fire with water, you know what I'm saying? Love or whatever. You know what I'm saying? You can see a problem. You can hate your enemy, but that don't mean you got to, you know what I'm saying, go at him with a gun and all that. You just gotta know how to give him the water to change his eye, his way of life or whatever the case. You know? So your benefit and growth. So it's all about the whole world coming together. That's maybe why rap is like that. Rap is not singing and all that. Rap is just straight out talking. And maybe that's why it's like that. Maybe that was what God wanted to happen. Maybe he just wants the whole world to hear somebody say, y'all, what's going on? Straighten up.
Yo, what's up?
Yo.
You ready, son?
Clock hit one time. Say what?
When I met you, I admit my first thought was a trick.
Hands in the air.
You look so good. I suck on your daddy's dick. I never felt that way in my life.
That's right.
It didn't take long before I made you my wife. Got no rings, this shit just my main squeeze. Coming to the crib, even had a set of keys.
That's right.
During the days, you helped me back up my nickels.
Come on.
In the process, I admit I tripped a little. But you was my bitch. The one who never snitched.
That's right.
Love me when I'm broke or when I'm 50 fucking rich. And I admit, when the time is right, the wine is right, I treat you right. You talk slick, I beat you
just
right.
Just me and my bitch, just me and my bitch. Yeah, just me and my bitch. Yeah, just me and my bitch. Just me and my bitch. Yeah, just me and my bitch. All the girls with the real hair. Yeah, just the girls with the real hair. Yeah, let me hear you say yeah. Rollin' with this one and that one, pullin' out guns for fun. But it was just a dream, but a team wasn't me. Started smoking booze at 16 and running up in dates, doing hits for high stakes, making my ways on fire skates. But no question, I was feed for cracks and weed. The combination made my eyes bleed. But no question, I would blow on, try to get the dough on. Taking the white boys of ball courts.
Think I'm gonna go for that. I'm Snoop Dogg on the mic with the gangster rap. I got my nigga kicking free to the right of me. Fucking it up in Philly, so illy, silly, billy, dilly, willy. I can't stop, yes, I got to speak. Come on, Snoop Dogg, drop another gangster hit. Come on, yeah, and yeah, yeah, don't stop.
Cause it's 187 on a motherfucking
car. I can't hear you, yeah, and yeah, don't stop. Cause it's, I can't hear you,
yeah, yeah,
I can't hear you, and yeah, don't stop. Cause it's, everybody come on,
yeah,
and yeah, don't stop. Six,
yeah,
four,
wow,
five.
Hey.
How many niggas in
the place get high?
I do.
Do you wanna smoke with me?
I do.
Do you wanna smoke with me?
Yeah.
I got a joint in my pocket. Can I light the motherfucker like a rocket?
Hey, hey, yeah.
I got a joint in my pocket. Can I light the motherfucker like a rocket?
Let's go! Throw your hands in the air and wave them like you just don't care. And if you wanna be down with the king for free, everybody say, oh yeah! Was it ever wrote, bam, not meant for a hole like a slow tip. Check it, sucker MCs can never sway with me.
Wow.
Because of all the things that I play with D. Only G.O.D.
could be a king to me.
And if the G.O.D. be in me, then the king I be. The microphone is ready when it's handed to me. I was planning on his planet and I plan to MC. The MC fiends always seek the dream that I rock on the world and the society. I bring this on the stage and flip a tune of fern.
What?
Praise this to me, praise this to the universe.
Ooh.
My lyrics is
low.
I keep it hardcore. I can never swear your water.